It's only famine and hunger. Amen. Hallelujah. Sometimes, mga kapatid, amen, we think that God is a killjoy. Amen. We think, amen, that God doesn't want us to have fun. Kaya marami po siya may pinababawal, mga kapatid, amen. But God is not a killjoy. Amen. The reason why He said, do not do this and do not do that, do not cross the line, because He knew, amen, that on the other side of that line, there is only pain and death. On the other side of that line, there's nothing out there. Don't believe the lies of the enemy. Amen. Hallelujah. That helps you. Amen. There is a better life. Amen. Hallelujah. On the other side of the line, it's more far on the other side of the line. Don't believe the lies of the enemy. Amen. The Bible tells us in Psalm chapter 16, verse 6, the lights are fallen unto me in pleasant places. Yeah, I have a goodly heritage. Amen. God said, amen, hallelujah, that this side of the line, amen, are pleasant places. Praise God. And that's the reason why God put you on this side of the line. Hallelujah. Because He wants you, amen, to have fun. He wants you to have the best life. He wants, amen, you to enjoy life. He put you, amen, in pleasant places. Amen. Praise God. And He said, do not cross that line. Because on the other side of that line, it's no longer pleasant places. Amen. It's a place of famine. It's a place of hunger. It's a place of death. It's a place of pain. Do not cross that line. Hallelujah. Because there's nothing out there. Amen. Do not believe the lies of the enemy. When the enemy tells you it's more hard, amen, to be in the world and to live in the world. Amen. That's a lie. God loves you so much. Amen, that He doesn't want you to take the road to perdition. And that's the reason why He said, amen, do not cross the line. There's nothing out there but pain and death. Don't leave the church. Don't backslide. Everything that you need is in the Father's house. Everything that you need is in the church. Amen, hallelujah. Luke chapter 15, verse 17, and when He came to Himself, He said, how many hired servants of my fathers have bread enough and to spare, and I perish with hunger, and I will arise and go to my father and will say unto him, Father, I have sinned against heaven and before thee. Do you know what made the prodigal son go back to his father? Because first of all, amen, hallelujah, he realized, amen, his life. He remembered his life in his father's house. How good his life was. Praise God, that everything that he needed was supplied. Praise God, hallelujah. But he was in this place, hungry, with nothing. And that's the reason why he went back. Because he remembered how good his life was. As I was preparing this message, amen, I heard the testimony of this woman, lady, amen. And let me just mention to you her testimony, because it's in connection to what I'm sharing to you, amen, this morning. Praise God. This lady grew up in the church. He, amen, lived in the presence of our Heavenly Father for 25 years. And then when she was 25, she decided to leave the church. She decided to backslide. Amen. She decided, amen, to go back to the world. And even though she knew the Word of God, even though she knew that God's Word doesn't allow her to marry an unbeliever, but she chose to marry an unbeliever, and that marriage ended up in a divorce. And she lived, amen, for the next 25 years of her life, going from one party to another party. Can you imagine that? For the next 25 years of her life. But on her 50s, amen, she decided to go back to the church. Amen. And her pastor asked her, why? What made her to come back to the church? Amen. She said, amen, my life is so miserable out there. I live my life, amen, for 25 years going from one party to another party. But I didn't find satisfaction. It's so lonely out there. It's so empty out there. Amen. Hallelujah. she said, amen, I was so devastated. And I was so empty, and I was so lonely, and I was so miserable. And what made me come back to church is because I remember my life.
Yes, sir.
In the church.
Come on now.
I remember how good it was.
Yes, sir.
Amen. And I missed it.
Come
and
on.
That's why I came back. I remember the joy. I remember the peace. I remember my relationship with God. I remember, amen, how good my life was. How beautiful my life was when I was in my Father's house. When I was living in the presence of the Lord. Amen. And that's what made me come back. Praise God. Listen, amen, to the story, to the testimony of this lady. There's nothing out there. There's nothing out there. Praise God. And the prodigal son said, I will arise and go to my father, because he realized that he was in the wrong place. And he wants to go back to the right place.
Amen.
Amen. The prodigal son lost everything. Amen. But when he came back, but when he knelt down before, amen, his father, and he asked for forgiveness, amen. Bible tells us, amen, that his father restored everything. He lost everything. It only takes, amen, asking for forgiveness in order for his father to restore everything.
My God.
I don't know, amen, if this message is for somebody or for someone tonight. Amen, if you've left, amen, the father's house, maybe not physically, amen, but amen, we call it backsliding in the heart.
Come on.
Amen. You've drifted away. Yes, physically you are inside the church, but you've drifted away from your relationship with God. And there's no more joy. And there's no more peace.
Yes, sir.
Amen. And you don't feel the presence of the Lord anymore.
Come on.
Amen. You go to the altar, amen, but you don't feel the presence of the Lord.
Come on.
Amen. It's time for you to come back. All you need to do, amen, is ask for his forgiveness. And he can restore everything. He can restore your joy. He can restore your peace. And he can restore your relationship with God. Whatever the devil has stolen, God can restore it to you. But if you are, amen, in the presence of the Lord right now, don't leave that place. If you are God's chosen place right now, don't leave that place. Amen. That's the first place to be, amen. Hallelujah.
God's presence. I love the Lord. Why don't you? some of my good friends out there, people that have preached to me when I was just a young convert. Brother Fortaleza, Kuya Fortaleza.
Yes, sir! Sorry.
In Jesus' name.
Yes.
You know, when I heard of Benji Terribly, Benji Terrible, that's an interesting name. But I grew up with great preachers like that, just a young boy in a church, amen. And I thank God for great apostolic men of God today. Yeah. Hallelujah. And it is good to have my friend, Brother Brock Chambers, in the house. Is in Jesus' name with me today, and I'm honored today to be in the kingdom of the Lord.
Right.
I don't know about you, but I am part Filipino.
Yeah.
This Lord is a true story. When I came to church, I was just a young boy, in Jesus' name. I went to a Filipino church. And my pastor was Filipino. He went to the national conference. So I feel honored to be here today. In Jesus' name. You know you're Filipino when? See, when I decided to live for Jesus, my daddy says, you gotta choose. You gotta choose. Whether to live for the Lord, or you're going to choose us.
Now, really? Homeboy.
I was like 18 years old. Brother, I'm telling you a true story, Brother Chavis. I was working at King Zone, was the name of the place, and I was making $5.85. And I remember the true story as I was there and I was praying, and my dad was serious. He says, fine, if you're gonna live for the Lord, you gotta get out of my house. I was like, well, I only made $5.85, so I started counting my pennies. I wasn't telling anybody in the church what was really going on. And God bless the Legatis today, that some way, somehow, I was praying. I believe the pastor says, pray and the Lord will answer your prayers. So I was praying, and one day they said, Brother Legatis came to me, says, the Lord's placed it on my heart that I was, my dad, the night before, my dad took all of my clothes, threw it on my bed, and says, I want you out. And I'm like, God, where art thou? You say, Lord, if I serve you. I went to church the next day, and Brother Legatis comes to me, and he says, the Lord's placed it on my heart that I should take you in. I'm like, let's go right now. Change your mind. So I lived with a bunch of Filipinos for about a couple of years until I graduated school. And you know you're Filipino, because when I left, you know what they gave me? Moments today. I'm not your ordinary teacher in the name of Jesus.